Jai Sri Krishna. Welcome you all to my channel Krishnavik. Today I am going to show you how do you install and configure Squid Proxy Server on your Red Hat Enterprise Linux 9 system. A proxy server is a server application that acts an intermediary between client requesting a resource and server providing that resource, with split and security mechanism for web traffic in computer networking. Squid Proxy is a brilliant tool that can be used in any organization to provide and control internet access security and boost web browsing speed. This is my Red Hat Enterprise Linux 9 system. Before you going to start installing Squid Proxy Server, check the repository list by this command. My repository has already configured. If you want to know how did I configure repositories, then click on the above I button. With this command, check your system's IP address, which must be configured by static method. Now type the following command to install Squid Proxy along with HTTPD tools security. Complete. Type the following command to enable the Squid Proxy service. Let's check the status of Squid Proxy service. Okay, active and running. By this command, we are going to copy the default Squid configuration file for backup purpose. It is quite necessary, especially for novice, because if you mess up the configuration file in any point, you can easily retrieve it. Let's check the status of our created Squid configuration backup file. Okay, done. Now create a file named blocked_site or whatever you want to deny access to your website as per your choice. This is a part of security and very essential for any organization. Type here the website name which you want to block, like this manner. For demonstration purpose, I am blocking here only facebook.com, but it can block multiple websites at once. Save and exit. Now type the following command to create a username and password to access websites through Squid Proxy server. Set a username here as per your choice. Like I am using Krishnavik as a username here. Set a password. Retype the password. Okay, done. Let's view the Squid password file. It's showing username and password. The password is in encrypted format for security reasons. Okay, let's check the NCSA authentication. NCSA auth allows Squid configuration to read and authenticate username and password information. After a while, when we will edit the Squid proxy configuration file, we need for this path. Let's edit the Squid proxy configuration file. Press insert key to enable the edit privilege. Type the following lines to set your server's IP and network. If you wish, you can set multiple network here, one after one. But for now, we don't want any other network. So disable all these lines, which are started with ACL localnet by pressing the hash sign in the front of each line. Necessary all ports are active. Let it be as it is if you don't have any other plan to do. Now tap the following lines to enable the password authentication security for website access. Press hash before the lines to disable the default website access privilege. Type the following line to enable authenticated website access. Default Squid proxy port number is 3128. Let it be as it is, but if you want, you can change it. One of the best features of the proxy server is that to enhance network performance by the website data caching to loading web page quickly. By removing the hash sign, uncomment or enable this line. In the following line, the number 100 shows the size of cache file in MB, 16 shows the number of directories and 256 shows the number of subdirectories in which the cache file is saved. We can change the size of the cache file. We can also change the quantity of directories, subdirectories and the location of the cache file directory. Also, we have to create one or more special IPs for few special personnel in the organization. Special IPs can access all websites without any restriction. Watch my steps.
I am creating here two special IP, 159 and 160 of the 192.168.220.0 networks.
Now type the following line to give full web access to special IP. Instead of using named special IP, you can use whatever you want. Now type the following line to activate the list of blocked site which we have created earlier. Instead of using named access denied, you can use any name along with the file location. Save and exit. Now restart the service of Squid Proxy. Okay, now type the following command to open all necessary ports to access Squid Proxy service through the firewall in the network. Reverse the firewall to implement the rules. Let's check the list of active ports on our server. Okay, all necessary ports for Squid Proxy service are opened through the firewall successfully. Now type the following command to test our Squid Proxy server with security configuration online. Target website redhat.com. Username Krishnavik. Password RHEL. Squid Proxy servers IP 192.168.220.200. Firewall port number 3128. It's working perfectly. Let's try the Squid Proxy connection from a Windows client system. This is my Windows 10 system. Let's open a Microsoft Edge web browser. Try to connect any website like google.com. Security prompt has come. Sign in to access this site. You have to type your username and password here, assigned by your Squid Proxy server. Click on sign in or press enter key. Okay, we are now successfully accessing the website, which has not blocked by the Squid Proxy server. Now let's try to access the website, which has been blocked by our Squid Proxy server, such as facebook.com. Nope, can't reach this page. It's quite natural according to our Squid Proxy configuration. Let's check the IP configuration. Let's change it to our assigned one of the special IP 160. Click on OK. OK. Close. Now just refresh the page. Done. We're successfully accessing the blocked website through the special IP. With the following command, we can check the Squid access log file to view all activity of Squid users. We have succeeded to install and configure Squid Proxy server in this tutorial. In my next tutorial video, I will show you the Squid Proxy client configuration and details. Hope this video will be useful to you. Please like, share and subscribe this channel to boost us to make more knowledgeable tutorial video. Thank you.